If you thought Vancouver's Grant Hardy would be an unlikely student of the fibre arts, you're not alone.
He'd be the first to agree, but let's just chalk it up to New Year's resolutions. He decided to go outside of his comfort zone and try something new and different. Challenge accepted.
There's a cold chill in the air this time of year, and there's nothing like a nice knitted scarf, hat, or mitts to keep the freezing cold out and the warmth in. With that in mind, I stopped by Unwind Knit and Fibre in Gibson's on the Sunshine Coast.
Hey Grant, you're here! Hi!
Hi, thanks for having me.
Great! Where owner Kim Fenton offered to teach me about the art and craft of working with yarn and fibre.
Our shop is unique because we are a dedicated yarn shop. We specialize in sustainable fibres. So it's really important to me and to my customers that we know where the fibers that we're working with come from.
Although knitting is an ancient craft, it shows no sign of slowing down.
I think now knitting has transcended into a recreational pastime. It's very calming, it's very meditative. It activates a part of the brain that we don't often activate in our technically advanced world. The community around knitting really transcends cultures, race, religion, socioeconomic background, because we can all knit.
That sounded very promising to this beginner. With Kim's help, I started off by learning how to spin some yarn out of two strands of fiber threads using a pedal-powered wooden spinning wheel.
This whole thing is powered by your body. The pedals turn the wheel and the wheel turns the bobbin. And you are going to use the power of the machine to feed the yarn through this orifice, which is at the front. And the yarn is going to come through the orifice and go onto this bobbin.
Okay. When I pedal, the machine draws the two threads of fiber through their separate bobbins at the bottom. They travel through my hands, which gently guide them as they twist together and collect in an empty bobbin at the top.
Got it. You got it.
Amazing.
That's it.
And once you've got some yarn, it's time to get knitting, or in my case, learn how to.
So when we knit, the process is take the stitches from one needle to the other needle. So we have a loaded needle
and
in our left hand and an empty needle in our right hand.
Okay.
And the process that we're going to do is knit the stitches, put the yarn through the existing loop on the left needle and move it to the right needle. And that's how we grow the knitting that we're doing.
Okay. It honestly sounded way more complicated than it was in practice, which was quite intimidating.
I think this takes up like literally all my brain power.
I got the hang of things much quicker than I expected to, and before I knew it, I had knitted an entire row.
Look at that.
Amazing.
It's a thing of beauty.
Lastly, it was time to try something a little more straightforward, felting. In this case, we were going to cover a bar of soap with wool to create felted soap. The wool acts as a gentle exfoliator, eliminating the need for a washcloth. I love efficiencies that save me time in the morning. Kim had set up a table with two mats, a bowl of water, and a bar of soap for each of us to work with. We started by pulling the fibers apart until we had shorter wisps of material to work with.
Pick your soap up, and you begin to lay those fibers on the soap. So you'll cover it from left to right and then cover it from up and down.
Okay.
Do you know what I mean? So you kind of want to cross-hatch the fibers.
It was time to add some water to our fiber-covered soaps.
So you can hear that I've got it quite wet. You know, I put a fair bit of water on my soap. Start making a motion of like washing your hands a little bit. Do you know what I mean? So you kind of want to get that, exactly. You kind of want to get that fiber stuck to the soap.
And finally, it was time to agitate the felt by rubbing the fiber-covered soap on our ribbed mats.
You want it to make a smooth cloth, so to speak, as opposed to felt little strands together.
Right.
So now we can begin to get a little bit rougher with it because we're well into this process.
Okay.
So we can start slapping it.
Okay.
Because what that does is it shocks the fibers into wanting to stick together. And then you let it dry.
Nice.
And that's it.
Love it. Love it, love it, love it.
That's it.
Felting project.
Yes.
And truly the most incredible way to use soap that I can imagine.
Good for Grant trying something new. I'd say he not only accepted the challenge, but he conquered it. If you want more info, their website is unwindknitandfibre.ca.
Felting and knitting are surprisingly easy hobbies to learn, even without sight. They're very tactile, and knitting needles are easy to use because of their size. It's good to know.